stuff with, and...
I think everybody got to know me in Monee Township.
We were sitting in the initial meeting where everybody, you know, that first Monday morning, 9 o'clock meeting, and so they had a speaker who was very outgoing, and he was trying to get people involved and everything, and he's like, okay, how many people in this room are threes, fours, and fives, and so, you know, I said, okay, wait a minute, I said, watch, wait a minute, we're gonna see Maurice up there in just a minute.
They didn't know I was there yet.
You know, I said, I don't know where Maurice is, because he hadn't, you know, we hadn't seen him, and I said, he's gonna come up there. So they had about 15 people up there.
Fourteen.
And then it looked like they were all done, and all of a sudden, here comes Maurice, I'm a five. You know, and he's all over the place. I just looked at everybody.
I think I shook 800 people heads.
And didn't I, Bobby? I just looked at everybody.
And I didn't even know they were there, I spotted them all.
And everybody, yeah, we didn't really...
Oh, that was a Kodak moment there.
Yeah, it was a Kodak moment, it was, you know, it was just as I expected, Maurice is here.
So I put Monee Township on the map, okay?
Everybody knows Monee Township is there.
So Joe, you'll be proud of us when you tell people who you represent.
I'm sure everybody else who was there for Monee would probably say, no, we're not for Monee.
No.
I kinda got that impression, because everybody here was up except theirs.
No, we love Maurice, we just knew it, though.
I said, I can't sit back here any longer, I'm a five!
I just knew he was going to be there.
I think I'll show the keynote speaker.
Yeah, I mean, he was as effervescent as the keynote speaker was.
I was like, literally, fumed. I don't know how that inner part of me, you know, he said, was introverted and things, you know, and all of that. So I really was at that point, like, I'm not gonna say one word or do one thing, I might go to sleep in this conference, I'm so tired. And all of a sudden, something within me said, get up, make that number 15. And you are a five. I'm like, I'm a five!
Anyway, it was a good conference,
and
we learned a few things.
A lot of things, and, you know,
yeah, so it was. I didn't learn things that I wanted to learn, which was I was kept asking every place I went, and I went to some affordable healthcare meetings, and I went to a GA meeting, asked a question, went to affordable healthcare, and everything was, okay, what is, you know, what's coming down for townships, and how is it going to affect townships on our GA program? And nobody really had an answer. Nobody had an answer. And it was like, well, now we've set up our, and in supervisors division, they're like, well, we've set up our meetings for the next the next few months. And not one of them had to do affordable care. And I'm like, excuse me, but I'm sure I'm not the only supervisor who wants to know how affordable care is going to affect our GA program. And I really think that it would be nice to have a meeting on that. And they're like, well, we can't tell you what we don't know. And I'm like, well, I understand that, but maybe by spring sometime you guys could plan a meeting, because by then wouldn't you have a little bit better idea as to how this should affect our GA clients? So anyway.
A lot of uncertainties.
Yeah, a lot of uncertainties.
We got a lot of, you know,
but, you know, they gave the best information they could, which was nothing. So it was helpful in a way. All right, clerk's report.
So basically, the only thing I have is I've got a request from the County Clerk's Office to file the list of statements that have been entered. So you'll be getting those letters. I have to file a list of people from this entity to that they will send a letter to.
Okay, so we'll be getting them in the mail from the clerk. When we get them, we have to make sure that we get them signed and sent back in for the spring, before the spring session.
It basically shows that everyone that was required to file last year.
Had already filed, right? Okay.
For last year.
Okay, and that's it?
That's it.
Okay. Highway Commissioner's report.
Well, we've got stuff already for snow. Plows are on, and everything's ready. April fixed up a big snow plow for that big wheel loader. So if it gets real bad, I have to use that thing. Also, I also went to Springfield, like Don said, and I went to 3 classes. Went to the flagger training school and with another one there for rights, right-of-ways, road right-of-ways. Do you know if you really get the right-of-way? And that's kind of scary. But anyhow, then I went to the one on drug testing. As most of you know, the county's on strike, which leaves me with a burden because all the road commissioners agreed to help the county through this time of labor dispute, which is getting more and more complicated for me personally. But I received a agreement, intergovernmental agreement. Joe seen it, I sent it over to him right away. I had some questions on it, but after reading it, it's an agreement that probably should have had years ago already between us. It goes both ways. You know, if I need help, they can help me. And if they're going to need help, I can help them. Hopefully, we won't need this. I'm hoping that they get together, get this thing solved. Because, like I say, there's a couple of us road commissioners here. But some of these employees live in our towns, and they went to our caucuses and got us in for road commissioner and voted for us. And now they feel like we're stabbing them in the back. Now, the way I look at it, this is a public safety issue with these roads. If they can't get through, well, then who's going to suffer? You know, buses can't get through, fire can't get through.
So what are they saying, honor their strike? Is that what this?
Basically, yeah. Yeah, they just don't care for us. To
they have fear on their...
Yeah, territory. Yeah. But that's what we look at it, well, like I say, we're looking at it as a public safety.
You know, I heard on the news that the judge ordered some of the rural county workers back to work.
Yeah.
Essential personnel.
Yeah.
The road district was, apartment folks?
No, that was a nursing home. Okay. Those over there, I understand, they're wild.
Yeah.
They're way out of control. But, so anyhow, we'll just have to see. I just got to, you know, they were going to get those agreements approved today at the county board meeting, and then they'll get them signed, and then we'll get them back. And I told my helpers, I said, we can't do anything until I get those agreements back.
Now, is the county going to pick up the bill on this?
Yeah. I got to keep track of it. And I won't go in there to pick up salt.
Okay.
I'll just take salt from here. I'm not going to cross pick lines. Right. Won't do that.
And they promised to deliver salt
yeah,
to you,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah. And so that hopefully that takes care of that. And then... And then we lucked out. Storm damage in our township was minimal. I don't know of any real bad storm damage in our township. I had one low-hanging wire in Crawford. I had to close the road to wait for ComEd to come fix that, to get it up high enough so people could go underneath it. So I just
yeah, I'm sure they fixed that right away, right?
Got it fixed yesterday.
Really?
Went down Sunday.
Keep talking.
And the only reason I got it fixed because it goes into the pipeline, feeds their...
Oh, that's not the only reason.
And I...
Okay. We get it, Dave.
Oh, okay. She sat there and waited for him to come. She said, I'm getting them out.
Next time, you should call your local trustee, and maybe he can help get it done faster.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
That's
right.
I'll give you my number. So, you know, this is for Maurice. Have you been contacted by the village for annexation in Heatherbrook? Okay, I understand they're out campaigning for that. Pre-annexation agreement. The mayor wants to get down to the airport.
Okay.
This is the rumor that's out there. They say they're going to give you better services, but yet look in the town, they haven't paved the street in 5 years. Look how I paved all the streets. All right, I won't say anymore. That should cover my report, that's been long enough.
I told you to come in and fix that wire.
I thank you for that.
Okay, so that's it, David?
Yeah, I gotta go, I got the furnace trouble at home. Happy Thanksgiving to all of you.
Thank you very much.
Yep.
Thanks for all your help with our Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, assessor is not here, and she didn't send a report, attorney, do you have a report?
Nothing to, yeah.
Standing, many remarks. All right, new business. University Lions Football has sent in a request for a social service agreement with them. They need some help, we have Ms. Bridget Simmons here, who's going to give us a little help, a little bit more about this and answer any questions that we have. But basically, they're looking for money. They have a trip that's gonna cost them $5,184, and plus another $700 in registration fees, plus then whatever the students have to pay themselves. And I guess we looked it up, we have not given to the Lions Club since 2009, is that correct?
2008.
2008.
$1,500.
$1,500 is what we gave them. So that's been a long time since they've come to us for any help at all. So, I've just got a couple questions on that, out of the money that you need to go, how much have you been able to raise so far?
Well, so far we've been able to do pretty good with fundraising. Our children, our wages level, which my son is on, which is the 7 and 8 year old level, they've been going out tagging. So we turned in about $736 alone that they collected in tagging. They've tagged for 2 Saturdays. And then varsity in the last couple weeks, I'm not sure if it was this past Saturday or the Saturday before last, they were able to go out and tag. And I believe they got around $400. And all the money that was raised is going towards the bus to get them down there, and it's also going towards our registration fees for both teams, because both teams have to pay, I believe, $250 for both teams. And none of the money includes feeding the children while they're down there, and it doesn't include feeding the families while they're there as well. And it also doesn't include any extras that they may need as far as clothes to keep them warm, like undergarments or extra long socks or undershirts, you know, long undershirts that the children may need in order to be united as a team and also stay warm during the games.
Now, if we're actually looking for donations?
Well, the letter that you all have now, I was able to send out a few different letters to Nike, to Adidas, to Cremonese School District. Well, that Cremonese School District has a foundation, so you don't give it to the school district, then you give it to the foundation. And then we also send it to some grocery stores to see if maybe we can get some gift cards from the grocery stores, you know, maybe to get them some juices, Gatorades, waters, things like that for their trip. And
how much are you making your fundraiser?
Well, we also did a fundraiser, which was a cookie dough fundraiser that all of the children had to do. And the children were required to sell at least 15 items. And with the fundraiser, we would receive 40% of all sales.
Now, this trip is next week, is that correct?
Yes.
So what happens if you don't come up with all the money?
Well, we are still, we're still fundraising. The fundraising doesn't end until we actually get on the bus to go. So we're still asking, we're still hoping that that some of the funds will kind of appear, or we'll be able to collect as much money as we can. I believe the varsity team is going out tagging this Saturday as well. So we will be able to go out tagging and asking people for donations for the trip.
We're cutting it pretty close there, so. I'm really meeting with the cookie sales. You don't know what that brought in.
I'm not sure what the cookie dough sales would be. I know that our team has 15 children on our squad, and I believe the varsity team has about 18. So if they sold all the 15. I know a lot of us, at least four of us on the Witches Squad, we was able to go beyond the call of duty because we was trying to help any of the children who lacked selling items. You know, some people's, some kids' parents, they're not allowed to sell at their jobs, it's cost of living, and they're not allowed to solicit at their jobs. So we understood that because we are one unit, we wanted to look out for each other. So a lot of us was really doing the best that we could to out, you know, to sell way more than 15 items. So it was a few of us that was able to sell more than 30 items.
All right, any other questions?
Does the Village University Park provide tunics?
That, no, not as of right now. Last year they did donate. Last year we had one team to go, and that was the varsity level. And they donated last year to them. As of right now, no, they haven't donated this year for the trip.
And you did send a letter asking them?
I didn't send that letter, but our board did ask them for a donation.
Never responded to
them. The varsity team is a defending Super Bowl champion.
Yes, and last year they went to Nashville and they came back in second place. And they, their tournament last year, they had over 70 teams. So they came back and they represented the University of Park very well, and very graciously.
And this is our teams that then helped with Creighton High School.
Absolutely. They provided a police escort to play the Country Club Bulls and during their championship season. That was a really cool.
Yeah, I'm back in the days when my son was little and it was the Mean Green Machine that we had at the University Park.
And this year, all of our children are growing up in the program, and we just had our banquet this past Sunday, and we had about eight of our children. They got a Lionheart Award, and Lionheart means that they pretty much was in the program since they were 7 years old. Mm-hmm. And so they about eight of them received a Lionheart Award because they've been in the program since they were 7 years old, and they're in eighth grade now, and they're getting ready to graduate to high school.
And she was able to provide us with a budget also that it was on the table. I did ask for that. We said we want to ask the budgets fund on any requests, and basically we did this picture. Yeah, with their main budget, this budget, what she has here is what they need just for the trip, and then this is their budget for the year that they have. And they have to basically just their money comes in through the registration and a little bit of fundraisers. And what they end up with spending is. What they spend is, and receive is just about the same. So. Is there any money all coming that they've been able to eat out of their regular budget to help with this cause?
As far as I know, if it was, maybe a little close to none. I know that we did a little fundraiser earlier in the year, well, earlier in the season, and I think that, no, I'm sorry, they had some money left over from their trip from last year when they went to Nashville. And they had about $400 left over from last year. And so that $400 helped with the deposit that they needed for a cost for this year's tournament.
Well, it's kind of hard because normally when we have baseball, football teams come to us, we are usually giving them between $500 and $700. And, this team has not come to us, and apparently the last time we gave them $1,500. So, I actually, because I'd like to see this team go, would like to see us maybe go up to $2,000 on this, but I don't know if we can go too much higher.
I was thinking more we could probably split the cost.
More like $2,500?
Yeah, because they haven't been to us each year. You know, certain teams come to us every year.
Right.
And they haven't been to us in 5 years.
I'd be okay with the 2,500.
Do you guys have your 501?
Yes.
You do?
Yes. Our assistant treasurer, Rhonda Benson, she has it.
Okay.
She has it in her possession.
Okay, that's for this organization?
Yes.
Organization?
Yes.
Okay.
You know, one thing you might want to do, so you might want to check with who is in charge of concession operation.
Yeah.
Now, this year with concession stand, we gave, PK's did the concession because the Lions didn't have the help that they needed for the concession stand, and I volunteered my services for next year's concession so that all the money can come back to the Lions because I do have my certificate. Yes.
Well, so you want to make a motion to try to help the Lions team out with the social service agreement?
Yeah, I'm going to be allocated $25,000 to University Park Lions.
And is this a social service agreement?
Yeah, that's a part of the process. You have to, yeah. In addition to social service agreement.
Second by Terry. Any further discussion? Seeing none, then on the roll call vote, please.
Trustee Rose?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Could you just clarify the motion again? Say it.
Yeah, I move that we provide $2,500 to University Park Lions football team. In addition to entering into the social service agreement.
Okay, and that's just for this year?
Right. That's to help you with that fundraiser. I mean, the trip, November 29th to December.
And let's specify for the trip, yeah.
It's to be used for the trip. Thanksgiving weekend classic football tournament, November 29th through December 2nd. December 1st, 2013.
Okay, and just clarity on the concession operation again?
No, that was just a missing item.
Because the Lions, we didn't have the concession this year. We gave it to the PK's restaurant catering. They're the ones that did the concession for us this year because they didn't have the help this year to do it, so they asked PK. But they gave a percentage. I'm not sure what the percentage was.
So
it was
they didn't
small,
have any cost.
It was a small percentage that they gave.
Yes. Because time is short, we'll have to get that agreement together and get their signature on it, get it back so I can sign it, and then we can get a check out as soon as possible.
Okay. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
We were born to work.
I do have a concern about University Park, but I'll say that for
the conversation. We have been here at all.
That's why I specified for this trip.
Yeah. We have help on meeting big time. And
yeah, they haven't been to us in 5 years, so that's, you know, that's how it helps.
Sustaining
themselves.
And we've been doing yearly things, so.
Thank you so much. And I do not run into those UP Lions on the streets acting crazy in the University Park, so that's a compliment.
This also helps them get out, out of this community. It allows them to be exposed to different cultures and different ethnicities and allow them to be exposed to diversity. And it's so much more than just a football team. It's like a family. It's a family unit. It teaches them, it gives them structure. It teaches them discipline. And it's just an awesome program. My son's been, he's only eight, but he's been in the program 4 or 5 years now. So it's a lot more than just football. And we also have people who grew up in the program to come back to volunteer and coach the children. So it's just, it's really an awesome experience, and we really do appreciate all the help.
It's been a great program for years out there, and like I said, my children are involved in that.
I do have one question, that after the vote was taken, it's very exciting, came on this ship, trustee, you know what I'm saying? And then he came on this ship, our attorney's hand, but he did not even vote.
She had my moral support.
Okay, all right, that was one question. All right.
Okay, so that's moving on to the next item, which is approves the tax levy ordinances. So you have the tax levy ordinance for the Monee Township portion, and then you also have the road district, the Monee Township Board is the general town fund and the general assistance. And the road is for the road district and for the equipment and building fund. And as in the past, we will have to have two separate motions on these. Levies is something that we do every year. This, and we can only, we are a tax cap county, so we cannot levy more than 5% over what was levied, what was done the year, what was actually extended to us by the county the year before. And so that's basically what David and I did. We went up 1.495, so we are under 5%. But, you know, all our monies are based on EAV evaluation. And our evaluation is going down, so we basically need to go up almost to that 5%, and just to try to stay a little even. That doesn't mean we will get what we asked for. Last year we asked for about the same amount, and I think we got not quite 3%. So, you know, the county can give us what they say we need, or what they think we need, or whatever, but sometimes they give you just nothing. I mean, they say no, you stay as you are. Sometimes they have their own little multiplier that they apply. So, but it was interesting that as I was looking at the levies that are net evaluation, that in 2000, the year 2010, well, let me see, year 2011, for the levy year 2010, we had an EAV of $354,142,918. And then for the levy year 2012, which for the year 2012, for the levy year 2011, it had gone down to $325 million with a loss of $28,205,374. And then last year, this is the spring when we got our levy in, which is the 2013 levy for the 2012 levy year, it had gone down to $291,366,895 for a loss of another $34,576,649. So in the last 2 years, actually, our EAV has gone down by $62 million plus. So yeah, it's going down a little bit, so that's just why, you know, we do have to, you know, levy to the fulls that we can, which is up to almost the 5%, and then hope that we can get enough money that comes in to keep us going.
The EAV definitely has been going down, but the offset that our rate has been going up here in the township to give us the money that we need.
And that's because the county has been adjusting little by little by little.
And just a little clarification on the 5% cap. We can go over 5% and ask, you know, go out there. We just have to put the truth in taxation.
Right. We have to do a black box levy and
right.
That. But at this point, we don't need to
we
do
don't
that.
Need to.
No, I mean, right now,
nor do we want to.
No, we don't want to go any higher than we are. We want to kind of try to at least maintain about the same level of money coming in, just enough to meet the cost, because cost on everything has gone up from paper to printing. To, I mean, you name it, it's gone up. So we don't want to gouge our ourselves, because we're all taxpayers. So we're just basically there to, we have to vote on a levy so that it will provide the dollars so that when we actually sit down and do our budgeting this in the January, February, or probably February, then we'll know that what we've asked for. So anyway, this is what we have.
So this tax levy ordinance that we have on our hands has only gone up 1.9% from what it was last year?
No. This is what was extended last year to us. This has gone up 1.495%.
1.495%.
And we cannot go over 5%.
So we ask for a little bit less than
5%. A little bit less than 5%.
And we probably get 3%.
Well, maybe, hopefully. Last year we got about 3%, so I'm hoping that we will the same. So anyway, we need a motion to...
Can we get the motion out? Again, I just want to ask a couple more questions after we get the motion out.
I'd like a motion to approve the Monee Township tax levy for the general fund and the GA fund.
I have a motion that we approve the Monee Township fund and the GA fund for tax purposes. Tax is going to be in purpose.
Questions, please?
Yeah, this kind of came out of the conference that we attended. Monee Township Board. So our general fund, as we're talking about levying, right around $600,000, right? Total.
$599,167, a combination of $550,843 for the town and
$48,324
for
general. Okay, just a little clarification on that. $850,000 or more a year. Now, does that include both roads
in the budget.
But did it just say exclusive?
That was, it said exclusive for doing the CPA, but here it says that the annual financial report for requirements for the state controller's office, an audit should accompany the AFR, annual financial report, if the township appropriates $850,000 or more. Is that combined?
That is done, yes, that's done. That is just the rope town there.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. If it's just the town, the general fund, then we do not have to appropriate that because we're $600,000. But if it's inclusive of both, because it doesn't say inclusive, Joe.
I think it says township.
It says township.
That's right, it does say township.
It says township, but it is inclusive.
That's right, okay, I want to clarify that.
If it says township, it doesn't just say.
Everything else said.
But no, this is part of what our, we pay the auditor for. The auditor does the audit, and then at the end of the audit, it sends the financial report to the comptroller's office. There is a report that I do that's done for the annual town meeting. That is, there's a couple reports, the annual financial report and something else. But then those are also then have to be filed in the clerk's office, not necessarily comptroller's office.
Okay.
And Bobby just published something in the paper that was small. Right, small version of what those reports. So we are fully covered with all our fiduciary duties that we are supposed to perform.
Okay, so I just missed some gaps here, so I just wanted to clarify what I think Terry and I was talking a bit.
That's why I get paid the big bucks.
Well, that's my God. So it's not any entrust in me, but I just wanted to bring it to the table, bring it out, and make sure there was clarity on my part and other trustees.
No, we follow everything, and we follow all the guidelines, and we are, we've actually had, there's been many, many townships that do, are very bad about this.
I do have one more challenge for you when the time comes up.
Even if the by chance you didn't follow, wouldn't we get notified by the state?
Yes, yes. Actually, the state was sending out a lot of notifications, was it last year or this year? Because many, many townships were not following the guidelines. And so we were kind of confused because we had, and so I think we'll contact them, and they said, oh, no, you're fine. You know, you're not talking about you. You do yours every year. You're good. And we're like, okay, good. Just want to make sure, you know, because we always want to make sure if the state wants something, we do it, you know.
Okay, great. Yeah.
All right, so we do have any more questions on the town MGA levy. Seeing none, may have a roll call vote, please.
Trustee Gold?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Supervisor Edmonds?
Yes. All right, I also need now a motion for the road district, which includes the general road fund and the equipment and building fund. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
By James?
Second.
By Reese? Is there any questions? Seeing none, may I have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Gold?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Supervisor Dabney?
Yes. Okay. All right, let's go into old business. Dial-a-ride. Well, our dial-a-ride started November 4th with our new pay system. And that first week was a rather rocky week, and we had many phone calls back and forth between county mobility manager and Willa and myself, and it was quite challenging. But I think the calls have really died down after the second week. I've had to ask Will County to revise their agreement with PACE because they had made it confining, and I just said to them, why did you make that? Because they listed that outside of the six township area, they were only going to go 14 places. And I said, no, any conversation that I've ever had was that you went with a 10-mile radius from our area. And they said, well, Payson wanted Maine. And I said, well, that doesn't, you know, if we've got somebody who wants to go to Walmart, they should be able to go to Walmart. If they want somebody that goes, you know, they had somebody that called them and said, well, I'm sorry, that's a grocery store that's not where we go. You can go to Burcott's and Montantino or Vietnam. And I'm saying, hey, my people in University Park, they go to the Jewel, you know, there they go to Dominic's. And then they said, well, you know, that's not in the agreement that we signed. And I said, well, let me tell you something, Nick. The agreement we assigned, we assigned that agreement in August. That was before you even had finalized your agreement with Pace. I said, so I think that, you know, and something changed between all our understanding. So they did agree that, yes, I was right, and that, so we are now, they are now going back to Pace, and they have outlined a 10-mile area, because Pace had to have something that they could put into their computers so their operators could work with, and so we do have people that are able to get to where they need to go. So, and also they, you know, they've double-checked that, like if somebody has to go to Hines, which isn't very often, they have the capacity to go to, take our people to Ridge Township, and then Ridge Township will carry them down when they do a Hines run, and then bring them back, and then the Pace will then pick them up again at Ridge Township. So, as I said, it was kind of a trying, that first week was awful, wasn't it?
Because it was also the first week that we was doing sign up for the holiday baskets.
Right, we're signing for Thanksgiving, for Christmas. I mean, yeah. The newsletter just came out, you know, so it was pretty hectic. But I think it's going along pretty well now. So that is one thing. We have a ridership report from Washington Township for October and November 1st. November 1st was the last day. What I did is I came in today and I put it into the computers, and I put the report that started in January of this year, showing that if you take in, because their last cumulative report showed as of September. Now my figures were $188 that we had in credit, and their report I think showed $1,000, so they were supposed to be doing or be looking at their report. I've not gotten anything since then.
Is that a separate one you sent
us?
It's on the table. And it says, it looks like it's a big spreadsheet.
Okay, I think we've done lines here.
Very safe talk today.
I know. Today?
All right. Okay, so as I said, what I did is I added in the October figures of what they were, you know, charging us. And so according to my spreadsheet, we owe them $6,786, but that's before they take, you know, add in their area aging grant. So down below, you'll see where I show the October for seniors was 150 of them, times the 25 that we use just as a basis. That does change. It usually goes up to about $31 when they add in extra costs. And so, but I took that was $37.50 times the 0.70, which is about what they end up with there at $18. So we owe $26.25. Then the October, November disabled was $152, came out to $3,800. We have nothing that we are paid back for on that. So right now, that we're showing that just for those, we're owed $6,425. What I'm suggesting is this. They probably won't do a cumulative report now until their end of December. They, like our township, like us, don't have a lot of extra money running around. And I think that there's about $1,000 question on their end, as if that's $1,000 credit or not, I'm suggesting that we pay them $5,000 into the account. That way, for my records, we'll still owe them $1,000-some, and hopefully, maybe I'm wrong, and they can go through their final report, and then we won't end up owing them very much at all. But at the end, I still think we probably will owe $1,000, but at least we're paying for what we have used, but yet and not everything, until they come to us with their last reports. Because what they do at the end of their 3-month period is like they do when they've done every month, is that they take the ridership and they take all the costs and then they divide the cost by the ridership and then figure out how many, you know, how much per ride. And it doesn't come to that $25 per ride, it usually comes to about $31 per ride. Something in that vicinity.
Ride is still $22 each way.
Yes, they are. It's when area aging is a donation basis, So was, and also if you were in the township, they were paying only a dollar. Then if you notice something funny about the November report, about halfway through the November report, they stopped showing fares. Because on the report that they sent over, there was a cover letter, she said, you'll notice that we stopped putting those fares that we collected in there because somebody complained that they didn't want the drivers to know how much they paid. So apparently somebody wasn't paying anything, or they were paying only a dollar. They didn't think it was the driver's business, and so Monee Township decided that they were not going to show the fares anymore, and they would just do it on a percentage basis and figure, you know, $2 per ride. So
then, is it $1 per ride round trip, $2?
Well, it's $2. It's $2 each way.
That's what I thought.
But if you're in Monee, and you're picked up in Monee, and you go to Docks, and then that's a dollar only. It's a dollar within the township. And then that's with this old system. The new system is always going to be $2 per ride within the township, $4 per ride outside of the township. Okay, but Washington, we always added it too. For some reason, Washington was only collecting a dollar for within the township because that was their thing they did within their township. So, yeah. But in the meantime, even, and I overestimated, if you'll notice in October where I've got an estimate of $545 fares, that's fares received. That's an estimate because I took the monies that they had on their sheet, added them up, and then estimated from the number of other riders that were listed, $2 per ride.
Right, October.
Go over to October, yeah, $545.
Yeah,
okay. They charged us initially for all riders $7,150 based on just $25 per ride. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Which, as I said, is now $31. So, and then, as I said, this fare they paid, they only paid out actually, according to my sheets, 200 and some, and I just estimated the other fare. So I could be very wrong on that. I don't know what they're going to come back with. The other costs will eventually come in, so it's paid up to $31 per ride. So we are going to owe them more than this $64.25 in the end. But that, I just wanted to kind of go through and get a rough estimate of where we were at.
When's the last time you gave them something?
We have not given them anything since July. We gave them $8,000. July, that $8,000 is the dollar that we paid out. That's all we've paid them in the, you know, since this fiscal year started, April 1st. So I think that if we pay them $5, we still will owe them money, but at least they aren't, they're not having to use their money to support our rides.
Any indication when we're going to receive some more AOA fund?
No. The Washington Township has the area aging grant until July of next year, okay? If for some reason they fail. Now what you must know right now is that Crete and Washington Township have decided to stay together. Crete likes, doesn't have many disabled rides. So they have mostly area aging. So they're coming out okay with Washington Township. But if for some reason that changes, and the county does have requests in to receive area aging funds for next year. And if they get that grant instead of Washington Township, then some things may change. Right now, we are in the guinea pigs program, and hopefully.
And how much are you looking for the cost again?
$5,000, which still leaves us probably a good $1,500 deal.
No. Look at the disbursement. Here. The general town fund. At the top.
Okay. Now we'll ask.
Well, that's not right. That's incorrect. Because we budgeted $30,000 for the battle ride.
Yes.
There's something wrong there. We'll have to go back and look at that. Because
no, you can.
Yeah.
Sorry.
There's $22,000 remaining there.
Yeah, we've got 30, yeah, you're gonna throw a number, because we've got 30.
No, it's just the line and others, and $10,000 is.
Right, other, and the dial-a-ride is $30,000.
Set on contract.
Yeah, that's right there, there's $8,000 against $30,000.
Okay.
She did ask me.
$5,000 is on case, it's a cover.
Yeah.
It's on the page.
No, this $5,000 is paid to Washington Township, where we owe them, because we have to finish out this. We will probably owe Washington Township, in January, I imagine, we'll have to, they'll have everything figured out hopefully, and then we will have a final payment to them. I don't expect it to be hopefully more than $2,000 at that time, if we pay the $5,000.
Now, what is that other time? What is that other?
The other means is when they go through, as I said, they use as a basis the $25, okay? That's what they put us on the monthly report.
Okay.
But, by the time they pay all the monthly expenses, for personnel, for gasoline, for drivers, for insurance, everything that takes to run a bus, they take all those expenses for a cumulative period of, say, September, July through September, okay? And then they, take out the, they take all the expenses out, then they add in the fare box, and then whatever's left is what has to be divided among the townships that are using the service. And that's where it comes in on cumulative report, which I gave you last month, you'll see where we had 22% or 27% of the ridership. So they discharge us 27% of all expenses. And then what happens is then, you've already been charged so much, so then I go through the reports and go, okay, they're saying that we owed $10,000, but I'm only showing that they had $7,000 in fees, so then I have to figure in the other that they were charged, is your $3,000, or their $6,000, or whatever it's there. But that's all the extra expenses, that's between the $25 per ride and the $31 or the $32 per ride, which is the end results.
Is this an appropriate way to capture my items like this?
It's the best way I know at this time, because we'll be getting different reports, because Washington Township has been so lousy with reports. But once we get over the county is going to have much better reports for us, and we will, and what they will do is they will actually, when we get December, when we get whatever we're owed, you know, we owe the county, and then the county is going to send us a bill where they will show all our expenses minus fares paid, minus the ridership, minus the grants. And that's what this also has, grants in there.
Well, we start with the county, terminate our relationship with Washington Township.
We did, as of November 1st, it's the last day Washington Township took our people.
November 1st.
November 1st, that's why you have a sheet here for November, and then for November 1, this is like $400. And then the rest of that was all for October. But then they started picking up on November 4th. And so then what the county then will give us, they will give us a bill in December for the November rides minus, you know, the bill will show everything, the cost, it'll show what we're getting through the RTA grant, which should be about 50% of every rider. So which in the long run, I think we're gonna come out ahead, because as you see, we've got about as many disabled riders as we have AOA riders.
And where are these county buses going to be deployed from?
They come from Joliet.
From Joliet.
They come from Joliet. You know, cost might be a little more, sorry. Now, if eventually, if, you know, we get some other people coming with us, and I think Will and Piaton are going to be coming with us, you know, but they don't have very many riders, so it's right now it's going to be Monee, and but it'll be interesting to see what our costs are to begin with. Anyway, what I'm looking for is a motion for to send Washington Township $5,000 to cover the cost of what we've already spent for them. So, moved by Terry, is there a second?
Second.
Second by James. Any further discussion on this? May I have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Gold? Trustee Brown?
Yes. Trustee Young?
Yes.
So we'll have that now.
Yes. Line item transfers. We have some line item transfers that were on the table. Couple of them have to do with, we're taking from contingencies for travel and training expenses, since we went over our budget amounts, I guess we can go into our summer conference that we went to and this conference, and what some bills that I know are coming in. We've tried to, make that there was a negative amount in these accounts, so we're trying to cover them. And the travel and training, we're trying to cover a little bit extra so that they will, hopefully, I've estimated enough to meet the expenses that are still outstanding. So the first one is the general town budget, where we want to move from contingencies $5,195, $600 to $505 by travel, from contingencies $5,195, $2,800 to $506 by training, and $5,195 contingencies, $200 to $5,125, which is dues and subscriptions. And those will be good. And then from line $5,600, debt service renovation loan, and then move $4,100 to $5,965, which is debt service interest. This last one is needed because when the auditor was here, she saw to see where we separated it out between what was actually owed for the debt service on the building. She wanted also an interest line. And since in the budget it only shows debt service, and because everything was figured into that one line, we then had a line item, $5,965, that we added in. And so he's transferred that money, so it'll be come back.
I'm looking for the $600 line item. Where's that?
It said the debt service. If you look in, under, here it is. debt service, or
that's all I'm saying.
It's a line item in the levy.
Okay.
That's all.
And all I'm saying is that if we were to do that, we do have a debt service that we borrow, right? And.
For capital outlay.
For capital outlay, I agree. And just to let the board know, we talked about the 5% cap. There's no cap when it comes to levying for debt, per se. See, that cap only deals with the other levy, you know, the levy body that we are looking for, you know, for other expenses and things of that nature to run the township. But when it comes to a separate levy for debt.
I understand that we can do that.
I saw, yeah, I'm just looking, I'm saying debt service.
I understand that is something we can do, but.
But we're not doing, so we're just capturing what our debt is, that we're paying our, I don't know, X amount of dollars to pay off whatever renovation.
Coming out of just a general fund rather than.
That's all, that's me. And I understand, I'm not looking at the budgetary items here. I'm just looking at how we are levying for debt.
No, we do not levy, we do not have a separate levy for that.
Yeah.
All right, is there a motion to approve the transfers as written? For the general town budget?
So.
Been moved by James, second. By Terry. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Bowles?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Supervisor Devlin?
Yes. The next one is the road district transfer, and it's the same thing. From his capital outlay of $5,600 to move $1,524.75 to line item 5965, which is the debt service interest. And that is the exact amount that we're showing out because out of the line, because he only pays 3 months out of his equipment and building for the renovation project. So this is done, this is already done. We have a signed copy. The copy you have is not signed. That Willa has the signed copy over there because David wasn't here when we had his Xerox on the table.
Is David gone? He's gone today.
And we have the signed copy. It's right there. We need to verify.
He signed it.
Right.
Okay.
So is there a motion, please, to make this transfer? For the road district budget. No, this is road district budget. Now, I'll ask why you do it separately. Road district budget for the equipment and building fund is marked at the top.
Okay, all right, that's coming out too, okay.
Right. The other one just comes out of your general fund.
I'll make a copy of it.
All right. There a motion to approve the road district budget transfer for the equipment and building fund as written? Can you verify that you have signed it?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Mayor.
And.
God love you guys. All right, may I have a motion, please?
So moved.
Moved by Maurice. Second by Terry. Roll call, please.
Trustee Bowles?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Supervisor Devlin?
Yes. All right, thank you, you're done. Okay, youth committee. Willa has given us a new table, a youth report of how many and within for the month of October. So we have that. Maurice, what else do you have?
Again, it's been very productive in my opinion. A couple more new families are coming and showing up. And we, Terry and I, talked to some people down in Springfield from a very, very, in my opinion, successful and a model for a new program that's being handled with Park Township. So I gave them our township email. They're going to send us something if they have not. I don't think so, but Willa will send me something. We just want to continue to benchmark with other townships to continue to make our youth program that much more successful.
Good idea.
Okay. So we're just pounding away.
We had a photography course taught for the first time. It went very, very well. So more to follow on that.
Now, Norma, your new volunteer.
Yes, she's very, very precise in her teaching. She had a very good student, my wife. My wife had to stop taking pictures. So, looking forward to doing other things with our little kids. We need to get involved and get the money for our kids. I know. Something's coming up we need to start talking about, because our days are soon to expire in December. We need to talk about the next phase. And by Governor State becoming a four-year university, they're trying to beef up their sports program. So they're going to be doing something with the floor. They're going to repair or replace their floor, from what I understand.
In the gym?
In the gym. So I need to see in court, just kind of correlate things on that nature. So I'll be talking with them, figure out exactly.
Still shutting down for a minute.
At least that part, not being able to use that.
Is it December or maybe January?
Yes.
We just need a date we can start back up.
Exactly. Okay. Or do we just want to use half or whatever? So I think I'll have more information in the December meeting, and I'll be able to better communicate. Okay, but overall it's going well. Okay.
Remind me that I have a question I need to ask you.
Okay.
Later on about the school board.
Okay.
Just thought. Okay, going green, anything?
Going green, I don't have anything, but I will have something. There's some other things I'm playing with going green.
Well, you know, we do have the link to going green on our website.
Okay.
I don't think we do, don't we, Mom?
Okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's constant, that's ongoing. If you'd like, we can, since it's kind of an ongoing thing, should we take the going green off the as a ongoing project then, because it's kind of...
Well, I think we need to continue to update that. I think it's a project, just like the youth.
Keep it on there. Okay, all right, just wanted to
double
check.
You make me feel wanted.
I'm glad that we can do that for you. Okay, let's go into the trustee audit of accounts. I'm going to start with down here with James here. This is the audit of accounts from October 18th through November 21st. We're showing a town fund, $47,696.17. General assistance, $2,815.93. Road bridge, $22,954.87. Zero equipment and bridge, zero bridges spent for a total of $73,466.97. So is there a motion to approve this, please?
So moved.
Moved by Marie, is there a second?
Second.
Second by Terry. Roll call.
There's a discussion here.
Well, let's have a little discussion.
Discussion, yeah. I'll pass this around. Just real quick. There's going to be discussion on this. It's going to be quick here. This again is kind of a result of the Springfield. This is the Dixon issue. You heard of the Dixon issue, right?
Oh yeah, they talked about that at
right.
the
conference. Right, they sure did, at the conference. So I just want to know what we're doing, and again, supervisors, not a reflection on you, lack of trust, anything like that. But just want to make sure we're doing the right thing with the taxpayers' money here. So this was a very simple thing that she did, being the Dixmore treasurer or controller, that what could have stopped this probably if she had two signatures when it came to checks. So I want to know, what's our process? I know you are a treasurer. What's the process? I know we approve things such as this. Is this as far as we go, or do you sign checks?
I only sign checks, and that's by state law. That's a lot. But if you look, pretty sure it's Joe, that's part of it. That's part of the supervisor's job. That the supervisor is the only
sole check signer.
Yes, that is by law.
So what happens if something happens?
If I die, well, too bad. I take it all money
from me. How easy would it be for us to continue business?
Pretty easy, because I think you just have to appoint a new supervisor right away at that next meeting. Right.
Make sure that's, you were talking earlier about the audits and stuff.
Sure.
Right, and that's all part of the audit too.
Right, because if there's a vacancy in the office of the supervisor, there has to be an audit within 6 months.
Okay.
That's one of the situations where even if you're under, that was when I was talking about less than $850,000.
Right.
Because if there's a vacancy that occurs, there's gotta be an audit.
Okay, so we're good as far as the way we go. Is that a policy? Do we have our internal policies? Do we have internal policies?
Actually, that's why we have the auditor. The auditor makes sure our internal policies are pretty well. What happens is that because we have one staff member.
Yes.
She does take in money and she takes it out. They, of course, are like two separate people doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have one person, then what they make sure that I do is that I have to check all every bank statements when they come in.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually physically look at them. I have to sign off on them.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to look at, you know, I look actually at all the bills and that are all the checks that are written. And, you know, kind of know that they're checks that are good checks and there are no funny names going. And, you know, so at this point in time, we are, you know, we're good financially. As I said, the auditor is very good about saying, okay, here's the areas that I think you need to beef up. And then when you say, well, I'm sorry, we have one person, you know, then it's like, okay, but at least do this. And that's, we, you know, follow every one of those.
Okay, I think I might have said Dixon more for the record. It's Dixon.
Well, you said Dixon.
Did it? Okay.
Whatever it is, it was a bad situation. But the problem is that their auditors, the thing is, she had a secret account. And that the auditors for 18 years were allowing money to be put into those accounts. And the auditors only work basically with information that they're given, and of course they didn't know about this account. But the problem there was that you can kind of see when you're looking at the amount of money that comes in, especially, see, and villages are much different than townships. Townships, there's a set amount of money that's coming in as taxpayers' money. We do get some extra money that comes in from pantry. You know, basically though, you know, and I suppose a little that we filtered out because we have dishonest people, but
Again, it's not a reflection, it's the process.
Right.
Not but a reflection. You know, as my grandmother used to say, there's so many wrongdoers in this world.
There are. And right now, though, the process, I think, is as good as it can get.
Okay, but I do, as far as our policies, so do we have electronic policies of what? I don't know. Yeah, there's policies on how or do we just go by our manuals and the state statutes? Do we have external policies or internal policies on driving a township? Or is that just the state statute codes that we go by?
Go by state statute
See,
code.
For example, we had came up with a policy for the mileage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Where did it go? Do we have other things like that? That's all I'm asking.
We have policy devised and those who work for the community.
We have an ethics policy because so that you know the trustees won't you know steal money.
Right. Somebody can come in and say, you know what, do a FOIA and say, let me see your policies.
Well, that's another thing the auditor looks at. She looks to make sure that people are correct and have taken the FOIA classes and all of that. Do you have to realize how important an auditor is? An auditor looks at all your procedures, looks at what you're doing,
and we follow the
standard accounting procedures.
And this is more so, not so much with accounting practices, it's just how we do business, period.
Right.
You know,
we follow the accounting procedures that as outlined by the state, and then as our auditor sees that we've strayed in any place at all, they go in, they look at everything, and then they make recommendations as to how we can fix it.
So what's driving us right now on how we operate the township is basically our township venues and things of that nature.
And the state financial statutes.
Okay.
And then, I think what you're asking is there like a codified group?
Yes.
There is no codified.
Okay. See that, you know, that minus procedure or policy, which we call it, it went over here. Along with our ethics policy, it went over here.
Now we
can go and say, okay, we have a group of policies right here that's driving how we operate in this township.
You have to realize that we are on a cash basis system, too, which is very different from
other
things.
We're not on a crew.
We've been on a cash basis for, I can't tell you how long. And that's noted every time in the audit. But it's very hard for people here to steal money for the simple fact that because we have a cash basis, and when we run out of all the monies that are showing in our various accounts, there is no more money. We can't accrue anything, we can't, you know, we can't make money like towns do, you know, where they say, oh yeah, you know, put it on credit.
It was just for me, when I hear the word policies, I'm like, okay, all right, show me where, you know, where we physically store the policies that I don't.
Well, our clerk has all my records.
Right.
So someplace, we would need Bobby.
Bobby
could probably pull together, but we'd have to go back and probably look through.
And if we don't, you know.
I don't know how close you have them in hand, because, you know, there were policies made about, like with the last assessor and people being able to sue people on the board and things like that.
If they don't have, you know, if they don't have a general place for it, that's okay, I'm not trying to shoot this, it's not working together, let's maybe we should come, you know, and say.
Willa has a file of general things.
Most of them.
Yeah, so whatever policy, and I'm not asking to look at it, nothing like that.
And then Bobby has these records, has them all.
That's fine, so if we, somebody say, okay, let's see the policies that you guys have, now here we are. So we can keep them in place, you, either you or Bobby, whatever, so I can, you know, I can share it, so.
Okay, have we voted on this? I don't think so.
No, we didn't.
We have, there's a motion and a second, by Mo and seconded by Terry, I believe, so may I have a roll call, please?
Trustee Bowles? Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Trustee Robinette?
Yes. Okay, board comments?
Yes, I've got one. Next month, I will be attending a workshop in regards to the recent state law that's going to go into effect in January next year regarding concealed carry. It's my opinion, and I'll know more after I attend this workshop, that we may have to develop a policy.
Policy?
We may have to develop a policy on the public entering our meetings with the concealed weapon, and then not members of law enforcement.
Do we actually need a policy, or can't we just put a sign in the window that says, no weapons?
I think both. So, well, let me.
They should do.
Yeah, I'll come back to the board, because information regarding it, as well as my recommendation. Of course, I'm sure.
So January 1st?
Yeah.
That's when a new law comes into effect.
Right.
Okay, so theoretically and hypothetically, someone can come to our meeting in January that's a non-law enforcer with a concealed weapon.
No, not that easy. They have to make application. Illinois State Police will make the application available. You have to apply, and then there's certain training that you must take.
Okay, so January 1st, that's...
The law becomes...
So to go through the process.
Yeah, to begin the process, okay.
Because the reason I ask is because maybe we want to come to our December meeting and have an action item.
No, not that quickly.
Okay.
Because let me find out more about it. I've done my research, preliminary research, but this class is specifically available for law enforcement.
Okay.
And I will be in attendance.
Yeah, there are some specific... locations where concealed carry doesn't apply.
Right.
I'm not sure whether posting a sign works for public, public versus private, you know, building. A private building, there is a reason to have a sign, can't bring a gun in. Not sure if that applies to public, and I did some research on concealed carry for another group I recognize. I'll bring that stuff next time. Because there are specific exceptions as to where you cannot bring weapons.
Yeah, which is a part of the law.
Right.
Okay, but I think also that, you hit it right ahead. This, even though it's a public meeting, I think there is some restriction that we can develop to ensure safety.
Okay, well.
You might go online, because they haven't had the training, somebody specifically brought up, and they have some contentious situations going on in their township, and so they were real concerned about that.
Yes.
So you'll let us know in December, bring yourself in December, so.
I'll bring the latest information, you know, some joking.
Well, can you make a note to put that on the December agenda, is just at this point in time, discussion? Or do we want to just put it on as an action item, just in case we want to take action? Do it as an action item, because, no, let's put it as an action, because even though it's action, you don't have to take action.
Okay.
It's just that if we want to, we can.
Yes.
So let's do it that way.
That's good.
Well, you know what I'm gonna have to do then? Yeah, okay, fine, I'll send you the information.
It doesn't mean we have to make action, but we can if we want to.
But it gives us an out.
Right, gives us the option there. Okay, that's good. Anybody other have a board comment? I just want to wish everybody a.
Sitting by him.
He's got a more bulletproof vest, all right, January 1st.
I wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving.
No, you can't do that.
And everybody have a good meeting, and then is everyone going to adjourn?
I echo that, and have a nice holiday, everyone, and I'm motion to adjourn.
Adjourn, is there a second?
Second.
Terry, go above, please.
Trustee Rhodes?
Yes.
Trustee Ryan?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Yes. What do you know about?
Adjourn.
Yeah.
Come on, let's don't push that, show that camera going off.